Hi, I'm Jesse Hoover, and today we're here at the farm of Mr. Malcolm Tucker. Mr. Malcolm is a tomato producer. He does some greenhouse tomatoes and a few field tomatoes as well in East Feliciana Parish. And between the Feliciana Parishes, we have 7 to 10 fruit and vegetable producers in the area. And one of the things that I worked with Dr. Fontenot on is we wanted to look at some biodegradable mulches to see in the field, in a field scenario, how these biodegradable mulches hold up and prevent weeds, and we compared them to a conventional mulch. Sometimes one of the hardest things at the end of the season is to pull up all that plastic mulch. It's hot, it's hard to get labor out here, it takes a lot of labor. And so we were looking at different things that we might could help farmers out with in our area to reduce their labor costs and reduce the amount of labor that they have to do in their field.
Okay, so one of the first things we need to look at when we're looking at mulches is having a control. And so if you look right down here, we've got our traditional plastic mulch that almost every single vegetable farmer is going to use if they're in the field. It's really durable. I can yank around on it. It's not going to degrade at all in the sun. This will be here almost 100% by the end of our season. It does a great job of holding back traditional grasses. You can see where we have weeds coming through here. They're either creeping in from the side, they're not growing up through it, or they're coming up at the holes. The one thing that this mulch is not good at holding back is nut sedge, like you see right here coming through right here. It pokes right through our traditional plastics very easily. Here we're in our plot with our biodegradable paper mulch, and our biodegradable paper mulch is a heavy duty mulch, and you're gonna see that this is 3 months after laying this mulch, it's starting to degrade and come up a little bit. That's a good thing because we want it to degrade by the end of the season. We don't want to have to spend money lifting this out. It does an excellent job holding down weeds at the beginning of the season, but as it degrades, you can see this is where we start to see some of the nut sedge popping through. At the beginning of the season, the nut sedge and the paper mulch comes up but lays down underneath the mulch rather than poking holes in it. The rest of these weeds are coming up from where we have holes with our tomato plants growing. Here we are in our last two mulch categories. These are both biodegradable corn-based plastic mulches. Okay, so they may not be organically labeled because the corn used to make them may have come from GMO-based corn, whereas the paper mulch is 100% great for organic growers. But what I want you to notice on these is, compared to that traditional plastic mulch, you're seeing a lot more breaking down here. Again, this is 3 months after. On that plastic mulch, I could pick it up and it was still very rubbery, whereas here, it just rips and breaks down, and it's gonna be almost completely degraded by about 4 months after application. We're at month 3 here. The thing I don't like about these corn-based biodegradable plastic mulches is, just like our regular traditional plastic mulch, the nut sedge pops up through them almost immediately. So when you're looking down, you're gonna see a lot of nut sedge holds in these early on in the season, whereas the paper mulch is still clean. The only negative side that I see right now to the paper mulch is the cost. Okay, so it's gonna be higher than your traditional plastic mulch and the ability to put it down easily. So if you're using a traditional plastic roller machine, you're going to have to really work on it to get that paper to go down smoothly. You have a few tendencies for it to tear at the beginning as you're rolling it out, but once you get it going smoothly, you can go miles with it. It just takes a lot of tinkering to get it down. So if you guys are commercial vegetable farmers and y'all are watching these videos and you have problems that you need help solving on your own farm, we are perfectly happy as LSU County agents and extension specialists to come out and do small plot work on your own farms.
And you can find out who your agent is by going to www.lsuagcenter.com. And on the homepage, we have a link that says Find Your Agent, and they are organized by parish. So click on your parish and find your county agent.